So in this line of research, we look at the performance of capitalism in Egypt. It's a broader theme to try to understand why Arab capitalism hasn't been very dynamic, why we don't see firms entering, more competition, more innovation. And we ask whether this is connected to the fact that political regimes were not open in the past and so could not afford to have the opposition finance itself from a free, open, competitive market, if you like. And so we focus on privileges and cronyism and ask whether it is a system of that system of privileges, cronyism, friends of the regime allowed to dominate the private sector that is the reason for these economies underperforming. We look at the case of Egypt and we find that in many ways the answer is yes, that Egypt could have performed much better in terms of economic growth and job creation if the privileges and the exclusion were not as much at play. In particular, we look at firm surveys and we ask questions such as, did the sectors dominated by privileges grow more? Were they more profitable? Did we see sufficient entry there? And we find that no, whenever there were privileges, for example, energy subsidies, whenever there was protection, for example, non-trade barriers, these sectors became dominated by friends of the regime that capture those rents, and that in those sectors there was not very much entry. The non-connected took a seat back, they could not compete. These are our main results. What we really try to do here is to open up a field so that researchers looking at the performance of the private sector look at it from a more political economy angle and also ask, are the sectors well regulated? Why yes, why not? We hope that this paper would be followed by many others.